Appreciate y'all for subscribing to the channel. Appreciate y'all for looking at the videos, logging in, hit that like button. Today we talking about Jeep and Eli dogs. And plus, I'm going to tell you how I got started into these dogs back when I was a teenager and who helped me get started in these dogs. In order to tell you this story, I gotta go back to where it all started from. My first pit bull was a boxer pit bull mix when I was 14 years old. And I thought that dog was the shit. You know, I thought that dog was everything. Boxer pit bull, you know, it didn't really show the traits of either dog. Now that I look back at it, it didn't show the pit bull traits. It wasn't really show the boxer traits. The daddy was a full-blooded boxer, but the mama was like maybe a boxer and a pit bull mix or something like that. But anyway, that's what I was rolling with, like when I was 14, you know what I'm saying? And then my friend, you know, that I'm telling you about on this video, he already had dogs, you know what I'm saying? He already had real pit bulls. Now my friend, I'm gonna call Mr. Wilson, you know what I'm saying? Now Mr. Wilson had more, he had dogs back then when I didn't really know what dogs was. He had knowledge of dogs when I was just getting into the dog game. He already knew what the pit bulls was, you know what I'm saying? Back then, he had a dog named Tank. You know what I'm saying? And that's during the same time I had a hole catcher. To let y'all know kind of what the time frame was. You know, in the late 90s, maybe about 98, 97, somewhere around that area. A little bit before. I mean, he had Tank before then, but the time frame that I'm talking about. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? He had real pit bulls. Like I told y'all, hole catcher was, you know, a mixed bulldog and pit bull. And I was, you know, learning certain things then. I had already had the red boy dog before hole catcher. But, you know, I was still learning stuff when I got hole catcher. And I didn't really know what I had when I had the red boy dog. You know what I'm saying? Because if I knew what I had then, you know what I'm saying, I'd have played the game a whole lot different. You know? But anyway, Mr. Wilson had dogs back then. You know what I'm saying? And he even wanted to really show me. And I really looked up to him back then and now still. You know what I'm saying? I looked up to him as far as how he took care of his dogs. He had a lot of dogs. I'm talking about, I had one dog, one mixed breed pit bull. He had a lot of dogs and all of them was healthy. All of them looked good, you know what I'm saying? I never seen them walking around and shit, you know what I'm saying? All of them, like they was good. I really aspired to have a yard. Like, I'm like, damn, he got a yard, you know what I'm saying? And one thing I realized today is in order to build a true dog man, you gotta have friends like Mr. Wilson when you're young, you know what I'm saying? And I say it like this, because we are two different people with two different personalities, but at the end of the day, we so much alike because through the dogs, you know what I'm saying? See, and one thing about me, I ain't gonna wait till a person gone or a person died or a person not here no more to say, oh man, that, he was the dog man, he was this and that. Nah, I'm gonna say it while you're here, bro. You know what I'm saying? You showed me and molded me a whole bunch of good stuff that I can take credit for today and say that you helped me to get right in certain situations, you know what I'm saying? If it wasn't for you, you know what I'm saying? I'm no telling where my dog career would have been as far as the knowledge that I learned, you know what I'm saying? And the things that I, you know what I'm saying? This is basically the things that I learned over the years, you know what I'm saying? You helped me out a lot. You showed me the right way to do things and not the wrong way. Like I look on Facebook and I see a lot of dog men, a lot of these old guys, man. Like, you got your dogs, you got these, I'm talking about top dollar dogs running around and shit all day long, man. And you like, there's nothing wrong with like, I was messing with Master Bulldogs about the crates and stuff, but if you can keep your dogs in crates, at least he's keeping his dogs clean and all that stuff like that. And you know, you never know, he just had them on a crate on a video or whatever, and I was just messing with him with the video, you know what I'm saying? But one thing I can say, a lot of these dogs, dog men on Facebook, you know what I'm saying? They be having their dogs in shitty ass cages and all kind of stuff, and they top quality dogs. You know what I'm saying? I never seen that with my friend, you know what I'm saying? Mr. Wilson. I never seen that, and I seen them with like a lot of dogs, probably more than half of you guys got on your yard today at one time. You know what I'm saying? And none of them skinny. Pelican Bay Kennels is trained to go. Trained to go. But the thing about it, I got that from Mr. Wilson. You know what I'm saying? Trained to go at any given time. You know what I'm saying? Any given time. No matter what, you can talk. But at any given time, Mr. Wilson was training to go. You know what I'm saying? And I seen that. I picked up on that. And it is what it is. And I mean this seriously. Like back when I didn't really know what the bloodlines was, like I said, I had the pure red boy dog. But I didn't really know what I had. You know what I'm saying? And when I was dealing with Mr. Puckett, I didn't really know who I was dealing with. You know what I'm saying? Until later on down the line in the years. But Mr. Wilson, he already had dogs. You know what I'm saying? He had real pit bulls. And you know what I'm saying? He was showing us, even though I steered to a certain bloodline that I liked. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Wilson always had good dogs. You know what I'm saying? Always. And it comes back to the conversation what I'm going to have with y'all later on in this video about the Jeep and the Eli dogs. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Wilson had some of the best bred that I seen Jeep Eli dogs. You know what I'm saying? And I talk that country shit, but Mr. Wilson is the true definition of country. You know what I'm saying? True definition. One thing I can say, and I say it with great pride, you know what I'm saying? When I was out the dog game, this is later on down the line, when I was out the dog game, Mr. Wilson was one of the few dog men that came through my yard and said, here go you a good dog, good pedigree dog, get right with him. Mr. Wilson was one of the only few people that did that, if not one of the only people that did that. You know what I'm saying? Come through, boom, get right. Come through, boom, get right. You know how it go when you might sell, you know what I'm saying, things go in the yard, get messed up or something like that. Mr. Wilson would come through, boom, get right. You know what I'm saying? And I can't, one thing about it, I gotta always be appreciative to a person like that. You know what I'm saying? You gotta always get a person like that their flowers while they living. Don't wait till they die or wait till something happen or wait, you know what I'm saying, things go wrong or this and that to say, you know, how much a person is appreciated throughout your life. So before we get into this Jeep and Eli talk, I want to say, Mr. Wilson, thank you for being to me what Custom Auto was to Mike Tyson, what Freddie Roach was to Manny Pacquiao. Appreciate you. Number love. Hope you're nothing but good success in the future with all your endeavors and all your things that you're working on. Pelican Bay Canines, let's get into this Jeep and Eli. Now this part right here, I'm not really telling y'all stuff. I'm asking you and telling you stuff at the same time. First thing I'm telling you is, we got Jeep and we got Eli, okay? I understand what y'all boys were saying about, you know, Eli was in Jeep background. I understand all that. Okay, boom. Let's get to, you know, and see an eye to eye on this. All right, Eli was in Jeep background, okay? Now, this is what I want to know. You know what I'm saying? 2021, you know, in the early years, you have great dogs right now today that are Jeep Eli crosses, you know. So how can it be a Jeep Eli cross if Jeep is really an Eli dog? You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that none of you are wrong. I'm just trying to ask a question. You know what I'm saying? And I really should be on live asking this, you know, because I can get the live response. But I'm doing it on the video. Why do we get such great dogs when we take the two? And the thing about it, the two breedings, Jeep dogs and the Eli dogs, are totally different. You know, they're giving you different traits. But when you take them and put them together, they're great. You know what I'm saying? You get some great crosses with them, with the Jeep Eli stuff, you know? So just kind of enlighten me. It's just my opinion, you know? I'm not right about everything. You know, just my opinion. I think on the Jeep side, once Eli put, you know what I'm saying, Eli was in Jeep background, but once it got the Jeep, I think, by the success that Jeep had and everything that went behind Jeep, I think it all stopped with Eli right there. You know, Eli's reputation, I think, comes from all the other dogs that he bred that made good dogs. You know what I'm saying? I don't think his reputation coming from being in the Jeep pedigree. You know, I think his reputation coming from all the other dogs he produced along with the stuff that he did, you know, and all the other dogs he produced and the dogs that they produced outside of Jeep. Because once it got the Jeep, Jeep pretty much made his own reputation and own, you know what I'm saying, line of dogs with own traits. And it didn't really, you know what I'm saying, tie back into the Eli stuff. And Eli stuff, people was, you know what I'm saying, breeding that back pure outside of the Jeep stuff with other Eli stuff, you know. So that's kind of why I think the Eli and the Jeep kind of differ because, yes, Eli is in Jeep background, but not much. Not much to really say it made a difference. But nevertheless, he is in the background. All right. But I think when Jeep made his mark in the game, I think that stopped everything in his, you know, in his pedigree. I think he was the beginning for that. You know, all right. So Jeep made that stuff. And then the stuff that people was breeding and getting the pure Eli stuff with, you know, that was the Eli stuff. That was the Eli stuff without the Jeep in it. Straight Eli. But when you take that and go back together with it, you make some pretty good dogs. And I can see that. And that goes back to what I was saying about Mr. Wilson earlier. Mr. Wilson had some of the best Jeep Eli dogs I've seen. But I don't know what to call them now since y'all say Jeep is Eli. I'm just saying, like, you know, certain dogs make their mark and erase certain things. Even though those dogs are in the pedigrees, you don't talk about them no more. You know what I'm saying? The dogs that made Eli, you know, there's a lot of great dogs that made Eli. But once Eli came, you stop hearing about the dogs in his pedigree. You just hearing about Eli, or whatever. So, you know what I'm saying? Once a dog makes a mark, that's what y'all dog man today are doing different from the dog man back in them days. Because once they dog made a mark, or once they got their dog, they didn't press the issue on all the bloodlines in the background. They was worrying about their dog that they had then and making a name for that particular dog. They wasn't trying to say, oh, Jeep is the man, he's the best Eli dog to roll around, the best Eli dog. Now they were saying, Jeep is the man, Eli's the man, he the best dog around. Not whatever he was produced off of, you know what I'm saying? And then once Eli started producing and, you know, it was like all the stuff behind Eli didn't matter. It was all about Eli himself. So, you know what I'm saying? Just enlighten me on some things if I'm wrong or if I'm right. And I'm not the type of person that always like to talk about what I got. You know what I'm saying? It's just I got to talk about what I got because I'm the only one on the video. I'm trying to deal with some of you guys. You know what I'm saying? If you want to put your kennels on the video or if you want to tell me about some of the old stories or, you know what I'm saying, however you want to do it, we can do it. I don't hate on nobody. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to these dogs, if you're talking about something legal or if you're talking about historical purposes and stuff from way back in the days, you know what I'm saying? Let's do it. Let's make the interviews happen. Let's make the pictures happen, the videos, whatever. You know what I'm saying? I'm with it. I don't care what bloodline you got. You know, I like all the bloods. You know what I'm saying? I'm a Red Boy Jocko and Jeep man through and through because I had my success in the dog game with the Red Boy Jocko and Jeep dog. So how can you knock that? You know what I'm saying? If you had all your success with a Bolio dog or a Chinaman dog, then you'll be saying, forget everything else besides the Chinaman dog. You know what I'm saying? That's just how it is. And that's just the way life is, and you gotta understand that. If a race car driver is having all his success with a certain kind of motor, he's gonna say, tell his people who's fixing his car that he want that motor, forget everything else. He want them cams and them pistons and all in his engine. That's what makes the dog game so good. And that's what makes, just like life, so many different dogs, so many different people that like so many different things. Nobody wants to be the same. That's one thing about the dog game. Nobody wants to be the same, no matter if you got the same blood or not. You still want something different than the person that got the same blood as you. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wants something different, you know? And I'm just going to say this right now. Like, anybody who know me, they know how I talk. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it may come out wrong on camera, and that's why I'm saying this now. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm a cool person. I'm easy to get along with. I don't think I'm no better than you. Nothing I got is no better than nothing you got. You know what I'm saying? But when it comes to these dogs, man, I feel like Kobe Bryant. I feel like Michael Jordan. I feel like Tom Brady. Not that I'm the best competitively. I feel competitive, man, when it comes to these dogs, man. And if you don't feel like you want to be the best, don't even come around me, you know what I'm saying? When it comes to these dogs, if you don't want the best out your dog, don't come around me, you know what I'm saying? Because that's how I'm getting down on mine. When it comes to this dog game, man, I feel like nobody's wrong. Everybody has their own opinions. And because I say this or you say that, neither one of us wrong. We just got our own opinions. And what you say might work. I don't even know what you saying work, and something I might not have the knowledge of, you know what I'm saying? Or vice versa. But it's just, you know, nobody's right. It's just a test game or experiment. You gotta find what's right for you and make it work, like I said before, man. That's whatever you like. At the end of the day, if you like your hound, I don't care what kind of hound it is, if you like and love your hound, that's what's gonna matter half the damn time. You know what I'm saying? If you love and you put that you and that dog got that bond together, you know what I'm saying? Like I told you before, man. A true game dog that's bred the right way, that got it in him, and you treat him like a pet, man, that's an unbreakable bond. Pelican Bay Kennels, man. Subscribe to the channel. Like the channel. Share it with your friends. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. Love y'all. I'm out.